Jack Gleason had an eye for a well-bred working dog. No ordinary pup would do the job. It was 1869. He'd seen more dogs than he could count, but none of them impressed him. None of them stood out until he met George Robertson in Casterton one day, who showed Jack his Scottish dogs, and Jack was blown away. He looked down at the litter, who were yapping for their mum, scrabbling round, carrying on, all except for one. With her eyes as bright as a moonlit night, her kindness shining through her sight, he could feel her warmth and intelligence. Loyal was she, he'd found his Kelpie. He offered to buy her, but Robertson refused. They only go to family, this one's for my nephew. But the nephew had a liking for Jack's strong and handsome colt. I'll swap my pup for your horse, but then you'll have to bolt. So they met down by the river, and the deal was done that night. It was the start of something special. Jack could feel it deep inside. With her eyes as bright as a moonlit night, her kindness shining through her sight, he could feel her warmth and intelligence. Loyal was she, he named Kelpie. Jack moved up north and broke her in along the way. She was worth more than three good men and proved it every day. Then came time to join her to a classy short-haired dog. His good mate Mark Tully had a collie he named Moss. From Forbes to Yarrawonga, Kelpie's pups would show their guile. In the woolshed or the paddock, with a mob or at a trial. A tiny little pup, he gave it all he had, and he never gave up. And Australians across the land are forever in his debt. The Kelpie dog, our best mate, Jack, we won't forget. With their eyes as bright as a moonlit night, their kindness shining through their sight, you can feel their warmth.